time is called ease.
No one's gonna know what you're doing.
This
can they hear us right now?
Do what?
Can they hear us right now?
Yeah. It's all good. Hey, everybody, MB's getting ready. He's powdering his nose. World's on.
Thank you.
I'm not.
I'll repeat the joke. But God damn it. It doesn't have its oomph.
Yeah, sorry everyone, we got disconnected. Fucking Charlie called to check in and see what's going on. Michael Benjamin, ladies and gentlemen!
Hey, it's me again! Yeah, I love fucking doing this again twice. I got a joke for you, apparently, that I'll say again.
Yeah, get a boy!
Love God, right? And the devil. Hail Satan. So there's these two homeless guys walking down the street. It's early in the morning, they're watching everyone go to work, and they're dreaming about being one of those people going to work, right? And then the other homeless guy says to the guy, says, hey, I have it. I have a ticket. I have a bus ticket. And well, it was a subway ticket. He didn't know the difference, so it doesn't matter. And he goes out there as the subway's approaching, and jumps out there in front of the subway, and it fucking just kills him instantly. And that's it. That's the end of the joke.
Oh, yeah. So, Michael just informed us all the letter E never exists. Oh, Pony Butter's in the chat. He just shot out Mongoloid.
Well, on top of the letter E, there's also the letter C, remember? Letter C, and then there's going to be future letters that will be eventually eliminated.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to go back to caveman style here. It won't be long.
Yeah, do you want to give everyone, like, how we pronounce the words now?
So, I mean, it's not that hard. I mean, you're not even really pronouncing E a lot when you're using the letter E in the spelling of the words. Like beer, it would just be burr, you know? It wouldn't need to be weird about it and just take away the E. And it's actually more productive. It would save time and save our health. That's what we care about, right, America, is our health and our safety. Right?
Tub World says, what is this guy talking about?
Well, if you were listening, you would know that I'm talking about saving time and energy on you and your life and on all of your family members. I don't know. I feel like I lost it. Wait, what was the joke again? Okay, so the joke, if you want me to define it, it's basically the guys are arguing over being one of these big, you know, people that are going to work every day, right? And the hustle and the bustle, that's what they dream of. They're homeless. But for some reason, their perspective is lost. And then the guy dies instantly by the train, right? And then who wins? The guy who died instantly in the train? Or the guy who gets to keep on living as a homeless person? That's the question I have to you folks. Yeah, that's the joke.
Steph says, look at this dirty motherfucker. And Pony Butter is... explanation doesn't help anyone understand.
Oh man, I thought it would. I really did. Usually explanation, isn't that what they say though? If you just explain a joke more, then it makes it funnier. That's not what they say at all.
Pony Butter says, I'm more CIF-bused. Oh, he left one of the E's in.
Oh, you're translating it for me then?
Thank you.
I understand.
Yeah.
You don't need to explain it to me.
Oh, yeah. Well, I understand. You're woke. You get it, so.
I invented this shit. The fuck you talking about? Well, thanks.
Hey, can everyone hear him all right? I'm not sure if the camera is positioned the other way.
I'm not sure if I'm loud enough either. I feel like I am. But you never know.
Yeah, I don't know. Okay, can everyone hear the master comedian Michael Benjamin all right? So he says, unfortunately.
Yeah. So that means just adequate, and that's what you want. Adequate is good. Unfortunately means he's desperate in his times and he needs some kind of outlet to amuse himself. So here I am.
So we did a pod earlier tonight about DMX.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
RIP DMX.
Yeah. Well, all you booze heads in the chat, what do you guys all think about DMX?
Yeah.
He's going to bring it to you.
X is going to bring it to you. No one? Nothing?
Nothing, man. Everyone went quiet. Yeah.
Fucking crickets, like goddamn chirpy chirps.
Yeah.
Don't you just wish sometimes you were a chirpy chirp?
It's
because when you talk about DMX, it's dangerous.
I know, or it's like, he's going to appear in the walls one of these nights, and it's not going to be my fault, I swear to God. I didn't summon it.
So you got any bits you can drop on these booze heads?
I do, but do they deserve it, though?
They chimed in for Michael Benjamin Live, so...
I'm trying to think of some of the shit that I didn't do the fucking last time. Sorry, it's been kind of hazy since I, So, okay, I recently got in a wreck, right? And this dude who hit me, he was an old guy. He was, like, in his 80s. And him and his wife were getting so pissed and trying to, like, at the cop, this lady cop, right? And was like, you know, these fucking young people, the way they drive crazy these days. And the lady cop was, like, trying to calm him down. Like, yes, sir, I know, I understand, blah, blah, blah. And here I am the whole time thinking, this maniac fucking caused a goddamn thing. And I'm still, like, mad because here I am in this situation. Then I find out, like, 2 days ago or a day ago, I'm at the tow yard, right? And the dude tells me that this guy had gotten in 6 fucking accidents with this same car since he purchased it. 2015 is how old the car is. So, and he's going to sit there and try to blame my ass, motherfucker. No, I don't think so. It was his fucking ass, and he's a fucking piece of shit driver, and, you know, that's what I have to say about that.
Yeah, so...
Okay, maybe it was a little bit of a rant about shit that's been happening in my life, but...
Yeah. Pony Butter...
I thought it was funny.
So. Yeah, it was good stuff. Yeah. Pony Butter said X would spit on this dude. And then Pony Butter also says MB should take off his shirt.
Hmm.
The OnlyFans are back.
So, X would spit on my blunt that he was wanting to roll up with me and smoke, but he wouldn't spit on me as a person, because me and him rep the same type of lifestyle. And me, I would take my shirt off for X, so yeah, if he would appear right now, I would take my shirt off for him. But no one else but him.
No one else but DMX.
I just feel like... I'm not representing the X body right now. You know what
You're mean? Out of shape a little bit because of the winter.
A little bit. And you know what's horrible is that, like, all it took, like I've told you, I can lose weight real quick too, but I can also gain the weight back real fast with the pizza and the fucking the bread and the cheese, man. That's that goddamn bread and cheese, man.
Pony Butter says X wouldn't give it to you the blunt to spit on.
I think he's saying he wouldn't waste his weed on you.
Is that what you're trying to say? Because, okay. Damn, bro, you got me good.
Did you just get fucking roasted?
I mean, I think he made me cum my pants.
Do you want to? You want to show everyone?
No, I mean, he don't deserve to see it. Ugh. He just. Well, first of all, I'm being sarcastic, dude.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Sorry.
You don't know me being sarcastic? You never know when I know. No one ever knows.
No.
Like, did you literally think he came in his pants right now?
Who knows with this guy?
I bet there's some cum in his pants, but from a different incident.
I feel like I'm so dry that no condiment in the world could make this hot dog edible.
Any ladies on this chat? If so, is this hot dog edible? Look at this guy.
That wasn't me burping, by the way. It was some female weirdo lady on the side.
I got a no! Exclamation mark! Exclamation mark! Exclamation mark!
Oh, come on! Hey, don't be turning down.
I'm a very giving lover, by the way. Or selfless lover too is a better word for it. So, I mean,
do you want to go into how you're a selfless lover?
Let's just say I'm not a fucking piece of shit DJ Khaled that says he doesn't, you know, do cuddlingus.
Would you like asshole?
Yeah, of course. What the fuck's wrong with you?
Yeah, what the fuck's wrong with you? Yeah, I mean, who doesn't like asshole these days?
I mean, if you're not licking asshole, then you might as well be dying at the surface of the sun.
Right on.
Yeah, that's a hot take.
I'll take. Oh, yeah, so last week I threw in a hot take. Pink Floyd's overrated.
Oh, yeah, so, okay. Okay, so I got a birthday gift of their Wall album, right? And it was it was great, right? Yeah. And that was like, this was like 20, 30 years ago, whatever. But I get what you're saying. If you're just listening to them and you're not either stoned or on tripping or something on them, then they are overrated a little bit.
So we got another comment. It says, you shouldn't touch the hot dogs of the mentally handicapped.
So it's not still mental awareness month anymore? You don't care about the mental...
There's people he loves, too.
Wow. Okay.
Do you want to give him some wokeness?
I'll have to look you up and sue you later. No, don't worry. I won't go full Bill Burr on you.
What did Bill Burr do?
I mean, he's done a lot of amazing things.
Pony Butter says, because of the defecation that might be on them dogs...
On them dogs.
What dogs? You got shit on your dick?
What dogs?
Seth says, during Mental Awareness Month, they take them to Disneyland. Fuck them.
Then you're right. I've never been to Disneyland. I've only been to Disney World. Let's do a GoFundMe for me right now to be able to go to Disneyland. Seth, you want to donate $5?
Yeah, feel free to donate $5.
I'm just saying, man. You brought it up. You brought it up.
Disney anything.
What do you mean, man?
That's going to beer and weed.
Pony Butter says, you called your dick a dry hot dog, Mongo.
I know what I said. It was hilarious. It was a great joke. I know. I give props to my jokes, but I try to stay humble about it, you know. I don't like to try to just squirt out. I mean, thank you. I guess that's all I gotta say. Thanks. Thanks, man. Thanks.
Shout out to you, Pony Butter.
Oh yeah, I forgot it is Pony Butter too. That's right.
Yeah. Well.
Well.
Spit some knowledge.
Yeah. Hold on, I had a thing earlier that I'm trying to remember that I fucking can't. God damn it. It was something, too. I'm about to steal this beer, too. Well, oh. Damn it, no, that's not.
What happens in March? Like, is there any big events you got? Like, are you about to hit the stand-up scene?
Oh, dude. 420 is going to happen here soon.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
What do you got going on for 420?
Nothing.
You ain't smoking out?
What I would always love to do, I don't know, this is coming from me. You guys maybe not. Maybe, tell me if you guys fucking relate to this at all. That I've always wanted to go to the Cannabis Cup. In the Netherlands and Amsterdam.
Mm-hmm.
And it's on my birthday of all times, too. It's like 3 or 4 days, you know, outward. Like, and you can be a judge and all this shit.
Do you think they let you be a judge?
No, all you have to do is pay like some couple $1,000 for all this shit to be unlimited everything and access and all this, you know. But what I was thinking though, is like, at some point, how are you able to judge how good this weed is compared to how good this weed and that weed was, you know?
When you straight smoke
like,
down.
Yeah, well, that's what I'm saying. Like, how spacing are they? And are they going to let them hit this one? Okay, one time. All right, get that shit away now and then do the next one, you know? I don't know. I just feel like I don't trust...
Do you write it down on a card?
That's what I would say. You have to do it as quickly as possible. Write it down on that card while it's fresh in your mind, saying how good this shit is. All right, pass next one. Oh, the one. Because there's been dudes that have won it like 3 and 4 times a year in a row where it was that good.
Would they give you like a piece of paper and a crayon?
Yeah, right. they make me think I made it the whole time.
When is your birthday?
Guy Party, November 20th. Guy Party, goes to the Cannabis Cup.
So they want to have Cannabis Cup on 420? They do it in November?
Well, it's like, okay, the harvest, right, is coming towards the fall and all that. Doesn't matter what part of the world you're in, you're mainly in that time period. Or the frame. Anyway, and then they're all getting it together, they're getting it ready. Like, this is from all around the world, right? I mean, I don't know. That's just when I do it.
Oh, right on.
I mean, it's fucking cool shit. I've never been. I just want to go.
Well, I feel like it'd be like what you just from what you said. Like, I'm like, is it like Beer Fest but with weed?
Yes, it's Beer Fest but with weed
and shit.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is. But it's not teams. It's like people.
You're testing other people's
weed.
It's
people. It's specific people. Like, it could be
you.
It could be you or me.
So you can smoke the most weed.
It could be you or me against... It's the people from across the country or world or whatever, you know?
But would it be like Beer Fest where the different countries are competing to see which country can smoke the most weed?
It's not like that, but I want it to be like that. I want there to be a weed fest with... before he dies, what's his name? Willie Nelson? And Chong and Cheech. Cheech and Chong.
Oh,
I want all three of them.
Singer?
I want all three
Nelson
of them.
Willie
Nelson. What did I say?
There's
Willie what?
Willie Anderson. He's a Bengals player.
Hooray!
Hooray! Yeah.
The USA team would be Cheech and Chong.
No, they're the judges. No, they're judges.
Maybe throw in like Snoop Dogg and Michael Benjamin.
They're the judges.
Jesus, that's a lineup.
You're forgetting. You don't even know there's Seth Rogen and Snoop and shit. You're forgetting? Believe me, I can think of other people than you can. They're the judges. Willie and Cheech and Chong are going to be the judges, right?
Are you on their level?
Remember at the end of Beer Fest when Willie Nelson pulled them aside?
Right.
Remember? That would be awesome.
But are you on their... Are you on Willie's level?
Oh, I am on Willie's level. But he actually stopped smoking.
He just eats edibles now.
Yeah, he just does edibles and I think vapes. He does vapes.
So I want to send a question out to the watchers. What do you guys think fucking Snoop Dogg would think of this dude? Or any of these judges, by the way. What do you think, Chester?
I think they would look at his head and be like, he has a special skull.
It's a weed-smoking skull.
Quit giving side view. Hey, quit giving side view opinions. That's only for me to do. Side view opinions of my head are only for me to do on stand-up. You didn't remember me telling you about the whole, that's what I did with the stand-up, the one of the first jokes I ever told on a stand-up was about me giving my mom cancer, but it wasn't HPV, because she wouldn't let me near that pussy since the way my head is all shaped, all fucked up and shit.
It's a beautiful head.
And I literally, like, turned to the side and all that shit with them. And I don't want to repeat jokes because you guys bring them back up.
So, Steph said Snoop Dogg would make a documentary video on MB in the wild. He wouldn't be able to explain anything. Just make disgruntled noises.
Well, like I said, we're taking the E out of everything.
That's where you're creating the goddamn man.
Taking the E. The E is gone. C is gone, too. We only need K and S for C things.
Pony Butter is adamant about you taking your shirt off.
Does he want the right nipple this time? I gave him the left nipple.
He must be a Stealth fan.
Hell yeah. Fuck the Wello or whatever in black.
All right, so R17, he says, throw some trash on the table. I want to see him chow down.
Chow down?
Throw bananas, he does.
No, I mean he's a trash eater, right?
How did you do that? How did you do that? How did you do that? This outside force, we'll call it God. Fucking goddamn it. Jesus Christ. Criminelli over here. Will you stop with your interference?
All right, so somebody called Quick Roast just joined the chat. He said, would anyone care for a joke or two?
Let's hear it.
You want to fucking, I don't know if he's going to roast you. But...
Here, let's hear it, buddy.
All right. Yeah, man, let's hear it. Do we have any garbage we can throw on the table for?
Hey, I hear a dog.
Do I hear a dog?
I heard.
Where the dogs? Oh, where the dogs? It. Where the dogs at?
I see. I knew it. I heard it. I knew it.
$5 to eat the beer-drenched paper towels.
Listen, kids, we're not in high school anymore where I ate chop for money.
How long did you eat chop for?
It was one time.
Just one time? So Quick Roast says, the beer says you're going to make bad decisions, but the shirt says it's too late.
I don't know if that's worse on the Bengals or Keystone.
Pony Butter says $7 to boof the paper towels.
Is boof the new kids on the block kind of sort of sexual connotation?
Like people would boof drugs and they'd shove it up their ass to get high.
I wanted him to say it.
Sorry.
God, you dickhead.
I know, I'm ruining everything.
Yeah, you do that. He's not a good co-host.
Seven generations of miserable family had to die in order for him to inherit those curtains. This one's for you, Quick Rose.
I forgot I meant to do that. Can't see what's behind door number one now, can you, cunt? Goddamn cunts. Right.
We gotta let the dog out.
Let the dogs out. We're going to let the dogs out, everyone. We're DMXing it, letting dogs out. Here she comes. Here he comes.
Let the dogs out. MB is live. His fans are fucking trying to get him to take a shirt off. What do you think he should take a shirt off?
Yes.
No.
Yes, take it off.
You got a female that's asking
you. Yeah, that. Dude. And Pony Butter. That might be a female or a fucking 15-year-old boy.
I threw a banana at him and knocked
over his beer. Yeah, he knocked over the beer. So eloquently he did so.
I meant to, like, throw it over the beer, but it didn't work.
Quick Roast says, this guy looks like he takes very painful shits.
Wow. I mean, I wish that was true because it's the exact opposite. I just have, like, you know... regular random shits of where I can't control it and then I shit my pants. You've never shit... I bet I've shit my pants more than you've ever shit your pants.
I see.
If you've never shit your pants in the middle of a fucking Little League baseball game, then motherfucker, you have nothing to talk about.
Says, he looks like he stands to wipe, too.
I do! Which, oh my god, I'm so glad you bring that up. I never knew there was a difference. So, his name is the Coon. The Coon used to bring up, he brought it up to up to me. He said, there's people that stand up. I was like, yeah, I do. He was like, nuh-uh. He was like, you stand up? And I was like, you sit? And I always thought, I always thought that my hand would either go in the water or whatever, you know? Or I was afraid it was going to go into water or something. Or go into fucking... my arm would go in the shit or something bad, you know? I don't know. So I tried it. I tried it, right? I tried it. Are you a sitter? Are you a sitter or a stander? Are you a sitter or a stander?
Me?
Yeah, you...
I'm a sitter.
Yeah, okay. So I tried the sitter thing, right? It was nice. I admit. I didn't have to get up and wipe my ass. But I feel like it's funny, though, when you've done something like... where your body's sore and you wake up in the morning and you got to shit and you're a stander. And you're like, oh, man. I got to get like way back there. And versus the sitting, I feel like is like less things you have to do.
So Pony Butter believes you just smear it up his back.
What?
Your shit. You don't even smear it. And then...
why would I smear it on my back?
When Chester gets back... R17's got, he wants to see you, Chester, bash a fucking chair against your head like the WWE. Want to see us do what? Hold on, I'll wait till Chester gets back. But Quick Roast is, says, our Bengals friend looks like he panics about whether he's taking a date to Applebee's or TGI Fridays.
It's O'Charlie's all day, bitch.
O'Charlie's? Why O'Charlie's over fucking...
Because it's Irish. What do you mean? Look at me, I'm Irish.
There you go.
That's not good enough? Alright, well, fuck off, bitches. I'll fight you now, motherfucker.
Quick Roast says, that was a great story. This town, I was hoping there was more to it.
God damn it.
You're getting roasted.
Well, no, what's funny is that I know that they want more. I just don't have it right now on top of my head to give them. But I looked through my phone and just glanced through the shit like I did last time. Because last time I was looking at the shit I had on my phone. And I would go spurt off the shit I had. And I've wasted my fucking memory right now.
Quick Roast is like, oh, he's Irish. I was going to guess sad. Pony Butter's like, shirt off.
That is funny.
Come on, MV, take it off.
You're a funny Pony Butter.
I don't know, dude. You got to roast Quick Roast.
What do you say?
You need a beer?
Sure.
You might as well beer up.
Give me that phone, my phone, so I can see what I have to say.
Oh, you got your notes? Where's your phone at?
It's over there in the charger.
All right.
Hold on, people. I have things in my head. I'm sorry. There's too many things in my head to, you know, organize my head. Hold on. Let's see what's on my phone, though.
Hey, man, there's $7 if you boof that shit.
Look what's on. Well, show it. Right. Look, Guy Party.
Guy Party.
Guy Party, bitches.
Yeah, if any of you guys haven't checked it out yet, check out Guy Party Podcast, anywhere you download podcasts.
Anywhere. Come
on the wild ride of Michael Benjamin.
So, I'm not sure. Maybe I did say this before, but fuck it. We'll just roll with it. If you are ever questioning your ability to pull out enough or quick enough with a lady friend or lady of the night, you need to think of it like this. Don't invest long term, short term gains, bro. All right, so get out of there like the stock market and fucking boom, as soon as you feel that shit happen, get the fuck out of there. You know, run as quickly as you possibly can. It's like this one time when this lady freaked the fuck out of me. When I was just literally walking home from getting groceries, she comes up to me out of nowhere. I keep on feeling like death is like surrounding me. She says, "Oh, honey, I'll pray for you." I'm like, "What the fuck? Who are you, lady?" And I ran the fuck away from her as quickly as possible. You don't go up to someone and say you're praying for them unless you know them. You know what I mean, man? That's fucking weird shit. You don't do that. That's gonna fuck someone up.
So, R17's impressed that you can read and write.
Someone named R17. Is that R17 or is it R17, bitch? That's what I thought.
Chester, they got money on you smashing a chair over his head.
Like a chair or a stool? Because I got both.
Pony Butter one.
How much?
How much for Chester to bash a chair over MB's head, WWE style? Pony Butter wants to know where Fatty Patty's at.
That's a you question.
Yeah, Steph wants to know who the fuck is having unprotected sex with you.
Who said anything about unprotected sex?
Oh, yeah, I don't know.
I still don't want to come with a condom with a chick that's a prostitute either. You think I'm that piece of shit? All right, cool. But guess what? Everyone's having unprotected sex with me. So there you go.
So Quick Roast says, so why is the guy on camera, but everyone else is off camera? It's like this is a fraternity pledge, but for middle-aged depressed people. our Deuce and 17 has got $10 on the chair smash. And we got $7 for the booth of the play. Man, you could buy cheese conies tomorrow.
Or you mean dentures, like every woman apparently thinks I need to have. Yeah, that's going to be an ongoing joke.
Do you want to show that you have actual teeth?
I do.
Look at them bad boys. Look at them chompers.
All my teeth. I got them all. I swear to God, man. No teeth taken away from me. No teeth taken away from me. I'm like Pinocchio. You won't take my nose away from me. No, no, no. Not my teeth. Not my teeth. I keep my teeth.
I keep my teeth.
Sorry, dogs. Dogs are mad at me.
But he's afraid of Michael Benjamin, and that's
not my fault that he senses my alpha.
Pony Butter says $20 to throw a stool at him, but actually red shirts feces.
He's not feeling it.
Quick Roast thinks it's too easy to roast Ohio. What do you think about NMB?
Well, that's what I was saying before. That I feel like we're cursed, but we're also got a lot of special people and talent that like only get successful when they leave Ohio. And it's hilarious because everyone's like, oh no, that's not true. But then instantly, as soon as they leave the border and get a job and... even just Indiana or Kentucky or some shit.
And so they say, fuck this guy, I want to see the dog.
Hey, guess what, buddy? The dog doesn't want to fucking see you.
The dog's scared of Michael. Can you blame him?
We're still waiting for you to boof that paper towel. Everyone should fear MB. He could still procreate. Come on, MB. What is he doing?
I'm reading. Hold on.
Oh.
Yeah, okay. So this is actually a thing. Like, I don't know. I just feel like anymore... porn doesn't even do it for me. I don't know about you guys. Like, it's like just reading anymore, you know? Where I'm just trying to figure out what's my favorite one, and I never get to the favorite one anymore. I feel like we've talked about this before, though. Yeah. Burp, burp, burp. Burp, burp. It's a whole bunch of... our language is going to be a whole bunch of signals of burps and fucking grunts. But anyway, like I said, the porn thing, like you're just trying to find that favorite thing, and you're not ever going to find it, and you don't find it, and you're like, well, I guess I'll just try to imagine with my own fucking thoughts, you know, without it. You never get it.
A lot of them are impressed that you know how to read, and $10 to toss your phone out the door.
You've already said about the reading thing. Don't repeat jokes, remember?
Tony Butter says nobody gets it.
What is there to get? What do you mean? Why are you watching then if you don't get it?
Exactly.
What are you trying to get? I don't even know what I get, man. What the fuck?
It's your fucking fault for watching.
I'm losing eyebrows over this fucking guy over here.
Somebody said they actually understood what you meant.
No, they didn't. Fuck them and whatever horse they're trying to ride in on. They didn't understand. I didn't even understand what I said. Maybe. I don't know. I have to go back and look and see.
I mean, shit, all the money they're throwing out to fucking hit you with chairs, throw shit at you, throw your fucking...
okay, oddly enough, I would do the chair thing, but not the doofing thing. No, but did you see that the movie that John Cena was in with, what's her name? Judd Apatow's wife? What's her name?
Oh.
You know who I'm talking about. She was It's Always 40 and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
You know. Ashley.
I don't know what her name is, but I know exactly who
it's
you're
like a man
about.
Name. It's a something man. Ashley man, Laura man, Amanda man. What's fucking Judd Apatow's wife's name? Something man. Leslie man. Leslie man. Anyway, they were all in this movie together, and they boofed. They did on the movie. They did the boofing, and John Cena did it, and it was hilarious because of that scene. It was so fucking stupid.
As somebody said, it's like watching someone have a stroke live.
Jesus Christ. She asked him a complicated question.
It's like watching Joe Biden trying to walk up some steps.
No, even better than that, it's like Trump. Are you gonna stop fucking laughing?
Sorry,
these days?
Dick.
Are you ever gonna stop laughing?
All right.
I feel like you can't control your laughter good enough. It's like trying to listen to 80s music.
That's a weird insult.
Yeah. He's getting angry.
Why is that a weird insult? I can't insult 80s music. What? 80s music is untouchable now? Oh, yeah. Now all the 80s trolls are going to come and be like, oh, yeah, motherfucker. We're going to kick your ass with your 80s. Yeah, that's right. Fuck you guys.
Don't you want people to, like, be able to, like, just uncontrollably
laugh? No, I don't want him to like, and then
yeah,
like.
Yeah, apparently
and then
he doesn't like people to laugh at his stand-up.
No, they're supposed to hate me first, and then I don't like them either, and then we mutually disagree with a lot of things, and we sometimes would get together and have fun. That's friends. Isn't that what you guys are?
For real? Is he retarded? Oh shit. Oh shit.
I don't know, do you guys watch the show Shark Tank? Do you guys watch the show Shark Tank? No? You're a dumb cunt motherfucker? Okay.
I would love to hear your idea for Shark Tank.
Do you got some ideas?
I have a couple of different ideas, but I feel like they wouldn't invest in them because you have to, the proof of, you know, sales and all that shit wouldn't be good enough. Like, think of, like, lava lamps type shit, right? But in different type of genres for, like, comics and music and everything. Does that make any sense? But I feel like,
so like
I don't think people would buy them. I don't think people would buy them though.
Like a Rick and Morty lava lamp.
Yes.
Okay.
But do you think people would? I don't think people would buy them. They'd have to be super cheap for people to buy them. I think.
Do people buy lava lamps now?
No. Okay, lava lamps idea out. There was another one that I had that I forget.
I think I'd rather see you as like a shark on Shark Tank.
I know, right?
Then, total, like,
the Mr. Wonderful.
Because then, like, the people, like, every other, like, shark would pass, but you'd have, like, some imagined money that you can spend an unlimited amount of, and you just invest in everything. Like, nobody would get denied. It'd get past, like, shark, Michael. Fucking approved. I will fund 100% of your company for no profit.
You hear that, folks? He's right, I would be the nice guy of the Shark Tank. I would be a little sharky with what I wanted, but I would still approve you for whatever you needed. But,
R17 says, trash taste modifier, best invention for MB to present the Shark Tank.
Trash taste modifier?
Yeah!
I feel like he's onto something, because it could be like a compactor of sort, to where you could use it to like, whatever's in that trash bin or whatever that they're putting in there. They could take those parts out, recycle them, reuse them, and distribute them to said whatever place and location. It's like I remember when I first thought of, like, okay, think about back in the day when the very first cave people or like hominids or whatever, like they were pooping,
way
right?
Back in the day.
They were pooping.
Pony
right?
Butter wants to know.
No,
red
I'm
shirts,
not
working
fucking
on your,
done. God damn
working
it,
on
talking,
your soul.
Motherfucker. Now they're talking about that. The first time they pooped, right? And imagine them going and like trying to show off maybe their poop and having different challenges because their poop was, you know, better looking than other people's poop back then. The manly poop.
Tubbs World says, no wonder why the Bengals lose so much. He's a fan. Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to laugh. Because, you know.
No, you can laugh.
Hanging out doing comedy shit. But, yeah.
Fucking, I'm just saying before, you couldn't control your laugh.
I mean, they're...
I was trying to say something before.
Someone ball gag him. Paying $30 to see it. We're getting the fucking money raised up to shut you the fuck up. Oh, sorry. I laughed again.
Once again, you're allowed to laugh. I was just saying at that time and place, you were laughing. I felt like...
Oh, $40 up the ball gag. Use dirty socks.
Send Venmo now.
Come socks.
You ain't got none.
Give me 10 minutes.
Oh, don't laugh. Don't laugh, motherfucker. Can't laugh.
That's not what I said. I just feel like we're all these horrible fucking things that we buy and use. I mean, I don't know. Yeah. I feel like it's kind of funny, though. Maybe, I don't know. Like, the shit that you eat, the different stuff you buy, like, whether it be rice or coffee and shit. And you're like, well, I get this type of coffee, I get this type of rice, or I get this type of fucking cereal or something. Like, okay. Well, what is that really saying about you, though? Is that saying that you're a maniac because you eat this type of cereal? Or is that because or you're a loner or a regular person, whatever that is, if you don't eat this type of cereal or coffee or rice?
No.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like there's too many decisions out there for us to decide what's what, like, and that's where gun control comes into play.
How is gun control a cereal? What the fuck?
Excellent segue. All
right,
dude. Quick roast left the chat because you were just too easy to fucking roast. It's like I want a challenge. Seth wants to know, MB, what's your best talent?
Getting ghetto women to bitch about $15.
By the way, I want to send a happy birthday shout out to one of my favorite booze heads, Preston. Happy birthday, homeboy.
Happy birthday.
There you go. Yeah. Happy birthday, bro.
Happy birthday.
So Pony Butter says, he's replying to Seth. MB, what's your best talent? Making everyone else miserable? Agreed, but I want to know what else said.
No, it's my best talent is not producing babies, unlike you other fucking schmucks.
Do you have some statistics? Like, is there an MB?
How do you have statistics on nothing?
Like, this many loads dumped, no babies.
Oh, you want that type of shit? How could I do that, though? I would have to be God.
I would put that on a baseball card.
You'd have to have, like, a stat of, like, how many times I've done that, though.
So out of 10 times.
10. Yeah, 10.
Is that wishful thinking?
So I went to this food survey really high, and I didn't think it was a food survey, though. I thought it was one of those surveys about if you like their customer service type shit, and they were going to give you like a $25 gift card to a food thing. I just knew it was something to do with food. So I go in there, and then they gave me like this survey about this food questions about what the food I ate. And I don't recall any of this food that they fucking gave me. I don't know what the fuck they're talking about. So I just marked like how we normally do. They told you, hey, and just put C for the right answer, right? So I just put C every fucking time. C, 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 C. And then after then, they say, see me later. And I'm like, what the fuck? No, I don't want to see you later. So I go see them later. They're like, we have some questions for you. I'm like, okay. I answered to the best of my knowledge and honestly, and I swear. I'm like, okay, sure, we believe you. But then when after I said it, they looked at each other all weirdly, you know, like they didn't believe me. And then they put handcuffs on me and they're like, you're coming with us. And I'm like, what did I do? I didn't do anything. And they're like, yeah, you did. You ate dog fucking food, man. You're not supposed to eat dog food in the state of Wisconsin. That's illegal. And I'm like, God damn, I didn't know that. I didn't even know it was dog food. When the hell did this even happen?
P-
Pony Butter wants to know, have you ever inseminated dumpster possums?
Why wouldn't it be dumpster raccoons? You don't know your fucking trash animals.
R17 stat, 36 mannequins fucked, no pregnancies.
That's the kind of stat I'm looking for.
And somebody is drunk right now and actually thinks this is funny.
And I love that because this is exactly the right answer. The right answer is, what I do is I get up and I go dress as Goldie Showers, and then I pick up women in the bathrooms after I take my shit off and I change into men's clothing when I get in the bathroom. And that's how you do it. That's all you gotta do. You gotta be willing to dress up a little differently.
Yeah, if anyone's in the chat that hasn't watched our YouTube page, check out MB and Drag, man. Plenty of Piss. It's a guy party on YouTube.
Is that some kind of reverse tranny trick?
Yeah. Like, you make them think that you're a woman. And then you have to, it's like the, you get inside first, right? Mm-hmm. I don't know about you guys, but I like to sometimes catch myself doing things I shouldn't be doing. And so I'll catch myself showing people things on my phone that, like, I don't even know these people, right? Like, I'm showing them fucking Plenty of Piss, and they're like, what is this? I'm like, it's Plenty of Piss. You should watch it. And then they're like, okay, well, I'll not talk to you again all night, buddy. You're weird. I'm like, thanks. What do they gotta say?
People are requesting a translator. And R17, I like the drunk walker better, too.
He likes the drunk walker better?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not saying it's not great. I like the drunk walker. Don't get me wrong.
I just feel like it was like the second...
R17
go, we got a better shot at
it. Yeah.
Well, we knew how to do it a little better.
We had better tries at it too. We hurried the Plenty of Piss.
Yeah, we rushed that. And we didn't film the second half till like 6 months later.
That's right. But yeah. Well, we got lucky though, just because of where we.
Fun filming that. Oh yeah. Oh, don't get me wrong. Yeah.
But we got lucky though too with the subway that let us.
Yeah.
Those kids said. If the owners were there when we were filming, they wouldn't have allowed us to. Remember? That's what they said.
Mm.
I don't know. It's still fun.
I hope at some point does owners see our video.
That's my subway, isn't it?
That is my subway.
So you know what you need to do for we can afford costumes for the future skits? Is boof that, $10. Chester fucking hits you with a chair, another $10. Yep. Chester throws shit at you.
I smashed him with a stool, I think I got 30.
I gotta go pee.
We can almost get a green screen. All right, MB's gotta take a potty break. I understand if you guys wanna leave. If not, hang back. He'll be back in like 5 minutes. Crickets, you wanna play an intermission song? He's probably in there eating the garbage in the bathroom, so he'll be back in a moment.
Oh no, I cleared it out.
Did you?
I know not to leave loose garbage around when you have an animal in the house.
Fucking Crickets failed on the play Where the Dog's At. Where the dogs at?
Play that DMX Christmas jingle.
Yeah. Chester, they're requesting you to go shake him while he pisses.
Like his dick, or like just like grab him by the shoulders and shake him?
I think just to make sure he's shaped clean. Until he had a seizure.
I assume he's that kind of dude that pulls his pants up way before he's finished. So he's always got like a quarter of his piss in his pants. At least a quarter. You pissed a little in your pants, right? Yeah, you did.
You talking about me?
Folks, he's back. In all his glory.
Hey. How? You doing?
All right.
Animal feels threatened.
So you want to do some closing thoughts, and we'll wrap this up here in a few minutes.
Yeah.
All right, booze heads. Anybody that's still joined in, hit them with some questions. We're about to wrap this shit show up. Gay party. Are you a beans and Franks kind of guy? The Franks under the beans?
What? Franks under the beans. I'm not sure I know what that means. And no, I'm not just trying to rhyme. And no, I know we only have such short time. I swear, please go on with your question.
All right, well, I don't know. Looks like everyone's dipping out. MB, you got any closing thoughts before we wrap this up?
I would just say everyone tune in and stay ready for some more material. And stay tuned to Guy Party, and we will bring you some more skits here soon. It's a matter of time. You know how it be. We're crazy.
So we got a couple more questions. At what age did you hit puberty?
What age do you think I hit puberty? That's a good question, because I can give you the answer. But what age do you think?
Pony Butter believes you need to be canceled.
Dude, I thought you were on my side, Pony Butter. What the hell?
He says Dr. Seuss was more talented, but he got canceled.
Yeah, but he was due time, though. Everyone's got their due time. They're 15 minutes, they're 50 years, or 150 years. Just give me my 150 years.
So, somebody's, are you 40 years old?
That was 3 and 4.
Bro. Oh, sorry. Jesus. Yeah, we got rid of E's earlier. I'm lost.
Oh, my God. Third and your, burr. Give me burr, your 3 year.
What the fuck? All right, folks. Well, thanks, everyone, for tuning in for MB Live. We might be back with another episode of this. We don't know. Are you going to come back and embrace the masses?
I'm
going
to try and do what I can to focus on you people. I know how important it is for you.
How important it is for them to tune into your Twitch.
It's mindless for you otherwise, and I would hate to deprive you of any such need.
And on that note, hey, thanks everyone for tuning in, and until the next time, Guy Party.
Guy Party.
Guy Party.
Guy Party.
Guy Party. Check y'all later, man. Thanks for tuning in. You guys rock. Guy Party forever.